Today's species spotlight is on a really cool, very unusual, pretty uncommon species of old world rat snake, and that is the Korean rat snake. Now, really quick, before we get into this really cool snake, I just want to very, very quickly apologize. I haven't been putting out as much regularly scheduled content the last couple weeks, and that's for two separate reasons. The first of which, I have been insanely busy dealing with the ranch side of this thing. So dealing with the birds, the livestock garden dogs, the property, all the things that deal with being a essentially hobby farm or a small time rancher is what has been taking almost all of my day and time and energy. And then in addition to that, we did in fact lose a couple of our animals. Speed Bump, our larger sulcata tortoise, unfortunately passed away due to a respiratory infection. And we also did lose a couple small little snakes. And it has just been really hard for me to deal with. I didn't feel it needed to have a full video because of, you know, all of the other negativity and stuff going on in our community from, you know, stuff that is slightly outside of our control that we're really trying to change, as well as, you know, with some of the people in our community that have just been going through a whole lot of stuff right now. Much props to you, Brian. I don't know how you can still get in front of the camera every single day. I've been having a really hard time with it. But again, I just want to keep everybody not in the dark, being transparent up front, keeping everybody up to date. So back to the Korean rat snake. Now, the Korean rat snake, or Elaphe Anomala, pretty sure I pronounced that right, as always, there's the Latin name, is very, very closely related to the Russian rat snake. Now, there are a few different, there are a few differences. So the Korean rat snake, obviously from Korea, but actually in a few other places as well. They're also found in kind of eastern central China and a few of the outlying regions surrounding Korea's and part of China. They do look very close to the Russian rat snakes. The Koreans typically are about 4.5 to 6 feet long. Most typically sit in that 4.5 to 5 foot range, usually staying right around 5 feet, but there are some big ones out there. They're, as adults, they look kind of a little bit more bland in coloration, to where they're usually a more kind of olive green to yellowish brown color on the top, and then the underbelly sometimes has kind of like a yellowish to white hue from their chin down. As babies, they look really interesting. They look kind of like a chalky gray white, almost like a gray rat snake with white and black banding on them. And in fact, as adults, sometimes they even retain that banding. I don't know whether or not that is in fact a trait or a line-based thing, an individual thing, or a locality. We don't know too much about the Korean rat snakes nearly as much as we do the Russian rat snakes. Now, these guys are a good size clubid, you know, a 6 foot rat snake. They're a little bit heavier bodied. They are very curious. They're very smart, just like the Russian rat snakes. And they are fairly easy to keep as well. Now, these guys just are found from parts of not essentially Southeast Asia, but Eastern Asia and that kind of somewhat temperate zone, but much further south than the Russian rat snakes. Most of which of the original stock we have, both do come out of China, however, but they do sit a little bit further south geographically. So they're active a little bit longer and at a little bit higher of temp. So you can't keep them as cool as the Russians, which for anybody who's used to working with snakes might in fact actually be even easier, because that temperature zone that we're used to thinking, you know, around the 80s is a little bit more compared to the Korean rats than the more popular, probably just because they're black, the Russian rat snakes. They're semi-arboreal, which means all of this translated in captivity means that you want to give them plenty of space. During their period of activity, they're fairly generalistic. They're usually eating different lizards, different birds, different mammals. Like a lot of species of snakes, and also lizards, I guess, they do in fact tend to favor more reptilian or cold-blooded, like frogs, tadpoles, and sometimes even fish, more ectothermic prey as juveniles, and as adults they tend to get a little bit more generalistic with much more warm or endothermic bodies like birds and mammals in their diets. So if we have a captive-born animal, which a lot of the animals that we have in the hobby are in fact captive-born and bred, usually means they're pretty easy to not only get going on feed, but it also makes it to where you can actually give them a wider prey variety, so a healthier diet in general. Now, the interesting thing about these guys is that for a very long time, a lot of people thought they were buying the Russian rat snake, when in fact they were actually buying the Korean rat snakes. Remember when I said what they look like as little guys, the little kind of chalk gray, white, and black kind of banded snake. Well, that looks almost identical to the Amur or the Russian rat snakes. Sometimes they can have a little bit yellow under their chin as juveniles, but also sometimes so can the Russian rats. So somebody would think they were buying, you know, either a large amount of babies or a pair or something from an importer, and then after 2 years they didn't color up and they ended up, oh, these are Korean rats, not the Russian rats. Dang it. And in fact, the video that you are seeing, as well as the animals, it's usually just the animals, but this time Braden Exotics also provided the video for these really cool Korean rat snakes. That's kind of how they ended up getting these, where someone thought they were getting the Russian rat snakes. And if I'm remembering the story incorrectly, I am sorry. I'm pretty sure this is what happened, is someone else wanted to get the Russian rats, grew them up. Oh no, they're Koreans. And so Braden Exotics took them on. Really, really cool, very uncommon species of snake. Supposedly, anecdotally, the Russian rats are very placid, very reluctant to bite, more wanting to get away. Supposedly, the Korean rats are a little bit more kind of stand your ground, typical rat snake behavior. But like with almost every snake out there, if you work with them long enough, you figure out their body language, what they're being stressed out about, and getting them used to different situations, they typically calm down and can make very great placid animals. They also typically, as comfortable, well-established adults, do have the habit of just kind of hanging out during the day. They're a more crepuscular animal, not strictly nocturnal or diurnal, but they do seem to be out more during daylight hours than many other species of commonly kept snakes. Really, really cool species of old world rat snake. Pretty uncommon. If I had to throw a label on if they were like a beginner or intermediate, I would say high level beginner to low level intermediate, just because of their size, their availability, the kind of space that they need in general, and arguably a pretty placid temperament. Really, really cool species of snake. Hopefully you guys enjoyed today's video. I have a whole playlist of, I'm getting close, if not over 50 different species in the Species Spotlight playlist. If you want to check that out, you can learn about a whole lot of different reptiles, not just snakes. Again, if you can, please like and subscribe, hit the bell notification. I'm doing a whole lot of actual shorts content. There's a really new cool series that, and except for this last one, I don't know what happened with the YouTube algorithm as far as the date of this will be released. It didn't seem to do very well, but United States of Reptiles. It's a whole series where I'm doing a different reptile from each state of the United States. If you guys really want to, if you can check that out, give me some good feedback. If you want to see other really kind of cool short playlisty type content, let me know, give me some ideas. I might try to get into that as well. I'm about halfway through with the states as far as recorded, uploaded, and scheduled. So I'll be looking into some more ideas once we kind of round those out or filling the gaps the rest of the week. Again, hopefully you enjoyed today's video. Thank you so much. Thank you everybody for, you know, the continued support when I let you guys in up to date on all that other stuff. It means the world to me to be able to do this and to share reptiles and these amazing animals with everybody, both in this little community that we're building and outreaching as well. Hope you're having a great day, and we'll catch you next time.